If I do video in Corona, many of you ask me to do it in V-Ray too. The same happens when I create video in V-Ray. Then you ask about the same in Corona. Let's fix this issue today. Let's start with cameras. Okay, so to create the camera in Corona, we have to choose the Corona cam from the standard cameras. V-Ray has its own category, so we need to choose the camera from there. V-Ray physical cam. We create it in the same way as a camera in Corona. Okay, we can turn on and off target. Or we can change its position by adjusting the target distance value. We have the same options in V-Ray. The film width in Corona is the same as what film gate in V-Ray. We can change either film of view or focal length. I always change the focal length. In V-Ray, it's called exactly the same. We need to check the field of view if we want to use it. But again, I always use focal length. Zoom factor, we have in both. These render engines are pretty similar and you can easily create things by watching tutorials dedicated to another one. It's like two languages from the same language family, for example, Spanish and Portuguese. So you don't know each word, but you can understand the context. Now, three of the most important parameters in the camera are ISO, f-stop, which is the f-number, and shutter speed. In V-Ray, it works the same, just naming is slightly different. We can turn on the motion blur here. In Corona, we can enable motion blur generated by camera movement and geometry. In V-Ray, we have just one option called motion blur. Similarly, the depth field, we need to check the option. The same for V-Ray. We have some other cool options in Corona though. We can override the focus. We can change the value. We can actually do the same in V-Ray by changing the focus distance value. But in Corona, we can additionally choose the object on which we want to focus. The tilt and shift option is called exactly the same in both render engines. We can either check the automatic option or adjust it manually by changing the values. Works the same in both. You can also find the clipping options in both. In Corona, it's in environment and clipping panel, while in V-Ray, it is in clipping and environment. So we can see that it's all pretty intuitive. This video wouldn't happen without our awesome sponsor, Globelens. So big thanks for them. You know that high quality is very important to me. Globelens models are not only very detailed and photorealistic, but also have really well done materials. You can buy individual models or bundles. It's very convenient. Let's say you work on a project in New Zealand. Just choose this bundle and you are covered. They create exact plant species. My client wants a jacaranda tree, so here it is. You get not only these models, but also different growth stages. Also, all the models are available in a GrowthX version, which is really important for me, as I am not locked to the models they have created and can adjust them to my need, like in this image. If you cannot find the model you need, don't worry, just email them and they will custom make it for you. I will put the link to their website in the corner and the description below. Now let's compare the lights. So in Corona, to create lights, we create Corona light. In V-Ray, you just need to choose V-Ray from the list and V-Ray light. We can easily guess where to change the size in both render engines. The naming is slightly different, but pretty obvious. I move both lights up, so they're above the sculpture. Anyway, we can go to the modify panel now to edit the lights feather. Let's start interactive rendering in both so we can see the results easily. First of all, we can change the intensity of the lights. The units are different though. In Corona, I always use default ones. By changing this value, we can control how strong the light source is. While in V-Ray, I typically use radiant power. And multiplier is equivalent to intensity in Corona. We can adjust the value to the effect we need. The next thing is the color of the light. We can choose any color we want from the color selector. Similarly in V-Ray. We can use the Kelvin scale in both as well. In Corona, we need to change the option to Kelvin temperature. While in V-Ray, we need to choose the temperature mode and then type the value we want. In both, we can change the directionality of the lights, making them more or less pointed. The naming is almost the same, it is just located in different places in light settings. It works exactly the same, we just need to choose the value from 0 to 1. Exclude include option works almost the same in both render engines. In Corona, we can pick from the list or from the scene. In V-Ray, we don't have the pick option, but we can select by name. In V-Ray, these sorts of changes sometimes doesn't update automatically, so we need to refresh the rendering. Further on, we have the visibility options. If we uncheck visible directly in Corona or check invisible in V-Ray, we'll get the same effect. Our light source won't be visible in the camera, but it will still cast light. Other than that, we can decide if we want to have the light visible in reflections or refractions. In V-Ray, we have more of these options. So here are minor differences, but other than this, everything is pretty similar. Now, to create an IES light in Corona, we can load the file in Corona Light. In V-Ray, we need to create another light object called V-Ray IES, and we can load the file there. So in V-Ray, we adjust the IES light here, while in Corona, we just change the settings of the Corona light. But basically, we can get pretty similar results. Now let's talk about the environmental light. In both cases, we change it in the environment and effects. We just need to enable the use map option and choose the correct map. In Corona, we can use Corona Sky, or if we want, we can upload HDRI. If this is the case, we need to choose Corona Bitmap. The same for V-Ray. We just need to choose V-Ray Sky instead, or V-Ray Bitmap, and choose the HDRI file we want. For Corona, we need to copy the map to the material editor and add the file from there. Let's start interactive rendering, so I will show you the main options to change. To adjust the map to the view, we can use the rotation option here. If we want to adjust the brightness of the map, we just scroll down to output and change the output amount value. In V-Ray, we also can adjust this thing similarly. We need to copy the map to the material editor first. In Corona, the type is automatically set up to spherical. In V-Ray, we need to change it manually here. Okay, the map is way too dark. We need to adjust the render multiplier value. The higher the value, the brighter the map. To change the position of the map, we can use horizontal rotation in the mapping. Now let's add the sun. I have Corona and V-Ray Sky added as the environmental map. Now to add sun in Corona, we have to choose Corona Sun from lights. In V-Ray, V-Ray Sun. Here, we have similar options to the previous type of lights. But in the end, you can see the clouds option that is available here from the latest version. We have the same in Corona, but we can turn it on in the Corona Sky instead. If you want to learn more about creating procedural clouds, watch my video on this topic. The link will be included in the description below. VFB windows are quite the same and have most of the options the same. Just the naming or place where we can find them is different. You can guess pretty much most of these things. The biggest issue you may have with LightMix and post-production in FrameBuffer, so I will discuss them in more detail. We can start with the LightMix. Let me show you. We have the LightMix panel in Corona here. However, firstly, we need to add the correct render element. In V-Ray, the LightMix is available in the layers panel at the end. We need to change the RGB to LightMix if we want to use it. But here, it's the same story. We have to add the correct render element. Let's do it now. In Corona, we can add light mix and then add light select to add specific lights to the layers. But there is a faster way to do it. We can go to the scene tab and click setup light mix. This way, the plugin will do the job for us. We need to choose the way how we want it to do it. I always use instance lights. In V-Ray, it's actually easier as we just need to add the light mix render element. If we want to add light manually to the layers, we can add light select. The plugin will do the job for us automatically and we can use the way we want in the render element settings. Instance lights to have the same effect. Okay, let's render. You can see that we get pretty similar layers. We have the environment layer, however, we don't have a sky in the scene, so it's empty. In V-Ray, the objects with the light material on them will be on the self-illumination layer, while in Corona, we can add it as a separate light select. In both, we have the rest layer for all unassigned lights. In V-Ray, we have an extra option to turn on and off all the layers at once, which is pretty handy. Anyway, working with LightMix is the same. We can change the intensity of any light layer. We can also change the color by picking it. Turning on and off the layers is an obvious thing. What I like about Corona is that we can copy the color from one layer to another. In V-Ray, we can change the color space to RGB as well, if we prefer. And to copy the color, we can just use the previous color from the list here. We can also use the Kelvin scale to choose the temperature of the lights. Okay, let's go further. The post-production in the frame buffer. In Corona, we have some basic layers added automatically, while in V-Ray, we need to add each from scratch. Anyway, we simply change the effects by adjusting the values. We can also add extra layers by clicking on the plus icon. We can also reset the values and create our own presets. In V-Ray, we don't have any layers added automatically, so we need to add them from the list. We can also save and load our own presets as in Corona. The layers are almost the same. Let me show you. We can adjust the exposure in V-Ray as well. Here, we additionally can adjust the highlight burn, which can be done with ACES-OT in Corona. And contrast is included in this layer as well. We can adjust the saturation by choosing hue saturation. In V-Ray, a hue and lightness are additional options. By adding white balance, we can change the temperature of the image similarly to in Corona, but we can change the magenta green tint from here as well. Here, we can also add the tint to the image by choosing a special color. In Corona, we have a separate layer for this. In both render engines, we can add extra layers more than once. In Corona, we have some additional layers that help with adjusting highlights and shadows. In V-Ray, we can just use Filmic Tone Map. In both render engines, we have curves that we can easily adjust. I prefer using curves in Photoshop anyway, so I won't use this too often. By the way, in V-Ray, we can change the blending modes and intensity. Adding ads is available in both, however only Corona has its own ones already included. In V-Ray, we need to have own LUTs. Anyway, we also have the background layer and mask layers only in V-Ray. I talked about it in one of my previous videos, so if you want to learn more, check out the link in the description. Additionally, we have a proportion guide that is not available in Corona. Okay, next we have bloom and glare effect here. In V-Ray, we need to enable the option here. Naming is a bit different. We can get an additional option here. In V-Ray, we need to scroll down. We can get quite similar results in both. The same for sharpening and blurring. Here, we can adjust denoising, but firstly, we'll need to add the denoising render element. In Corona, we can turn it on here. You can notice that most of the things are pretty much the same. Now, I will show you the materials and maps that I use the most often and their equivalents in both render engines. They differ a bit in naming and have some different options, but the name idea is pretty similar and it's easy to guess. I will start with the main materials we use, so Corona Physical Material and its equivalent in V-Ray, V-Ray Material. They basically work the same, you just need to keep in mind some things. First of all, in Corona, we use the metalness option to determine if something is metal or not, while in V-Ray, we turn on and off Fresnel refractions or adjust the values manually. The next thing is the color. For non-metals, it's like diffuse color, while for metals, it's the reflection color. In V-Ray, on the other hand, we have the color separately for the diffuse and reflections, no matter if we create metal or non-metal materials. Also, in V-Ray, reflections and refractions are separated. In Corona, we can control it here. Another thing to keep in mind is that in Corona, we change the values from 0 to 1. In V-Ray, we can achieve similar effects by changing the color from black to white. We can change the roughness mode to glossiness and vice versa in both. And finally, the displacement. In Corona, we can control it here. While in V-Ray, we can use the displace map and adjust its value. But most often, it's better to use V-Ray displacement modifier. Okay, now let's move to the other materials. The one I use often is Corona layered material. In V-Ray, we use V-Ray blend material. Corona light is another one that I use quite a lot. In V-Ray, the naming is pretty much the same. V-Ray light material. Next, Corona re-switch material to override some things in the material. In V-Ray, we use V-Ray override material, which is even more obvious. For the maps, Corona bitmap that we use for example to upload the HDRI. In V-Ray, it's V-Ray bitmap. Corona color, I use it from time to time. In V-Ray, it's V-Ray color. Corona distance is pretty handy to create materials that differ depending on the distance from particular things. In V-Ray, we use V-Ray distance. You can see that the naming is pretty much the same. Anyway, next, Corona Mix. In V-Ray, V-Ray Comp Texture. This one has a bit different option than Corona Mix, but the general idea is the same. Corona Multimap we use to create variations in materials. In V-Ray, we'll choose V-Ray Multi Sub Texture instead. Corona Normal to load RGB normal map files, and V-Ray Normal to do the same. Also, Corona UVW Randomizer is pretty self-explanatory, and V-Ray UVW Randomizer to do the same in V-Ray. In the end, Corona Front-Back to create materials that have different front and back materials like leaves, for instance. In V-Ray, we actually use the material, not the map to do so, and it's called V-Ray 2-Sided Material. Render settings are probably something that varies the most in both render engines. As Corona is more user-friendly, if you're already using V-Ray, you'll have no issues with switching. If we're talking another way around, then you will need to spend a bit more time understanding the concept. But now, you can use default settings for most of the parameters anyway and have good enough optimized settings, so not big deal either. Anyway, you don't have to worry as I have detailed videos on this topic already on the channel, so you can easily learn from them. I'll link all of them in the description below the video. If you want to learn more about visualization in both of these engines, join our course. Also, watch my other videos on similar topics that you may find useful. Bye bye!